such a conserved quantity, like your, I mean approximate conserved quantity, like your isospin is your strangeness. So again, this strangeness is not conserved in all particular interactions, it is conserved only for some certain interactions, which we'll be discussing a little later. So what is strange about these strangeness particles, right? Or your strangeness quantum number? It is these two things, which is they are not produced singly. You will see here, these two are the strange particles which are being produced. So they are not produced in a single manner. Not just sigma minus is not produced singly or k plus is not produced singly, right? They are produced in pairs. Another one is they are produced via strong interactions, but when they decay via weak interactions. So that is your strange quality about this strangeness particles. So here they are produced via strong interactions, and when they decay via weak interactions. Okay. So now what are the examples of your strangeness particles? So those are your kaons and hyperons, right? So hyperons meaning, so these are the examples of your hyperons. It's sigmas, your cascade, this is the symbol for your cascade, and your omegas. So these are called your hyperons. Hyperons meaning anything which is the particles which are baryons, but they are little heavier than your nucleons. Okay. So now we will be finding the formulas, I mean the strangeness value for these particles by making use of your Gell-Mann-Nissejima formula. So according to this formula, you have your Q equals to I3 plus B plus S by 2, right? Okay. Now, having said that, let me calculate the your S value for these particles. So let me do it one by one. For K plus, my Q is 1. My I3, because here the multiplicity is 2 for kaons, so what I have is their isospin value is because it's so doublet, right? So doublet meaning your isospin is going to be half, right? So now my I3 value will be plus half, because this is with a higher charge, right? So I discussed this in your isospin lectures. Now, your B value, this is a meson, right? So, kaons, they are mesons, hence your baryon number is 0 here. So, now making use of this formula, making use of these quantities here, I get 1 equals to half plus, this is 0, so S by 2, so that gives me half equals to S by 2, S is equals to 1, right? So S equals to 1 for your K plus. For K minus, you get Q equals to minus 1. My I3 is minus half. Again, it's a meson, hence your baryon number is 0. Now, making use of this, I get minus 1 equals to minus. Okay, that is not K minus, that is actually K 0, so hence it is 0. So it is minus half plus your B is 0 plus S by 2. Again, your S is 1. So for this particle also, your strangeness is 1. Now let us do for your another example, which say is your omega minus, for which your Q is minus 1, your I3, remember this omega is a single member in your family, right? So it's a singlet, I is 0, hence your I3 is also 0. So my B here, and because it's a baryon, so all baryons, they have my baryon number as 1, so I get my S using this formula as minus 1 equals to your 0 plus 1 plus S by 2. So that gives me minus 2 equals to S plus 1, right? So it is S equals to minus 3. So for this omega minus, it is S equals to minus 3. 3. So similarly, you can do for the others also. So you'll see that for k plus k minus, your both strangeness value is 1. And for your omega minus, it's minus 3. This is minus 1. So this 2, you can take it as your home assignment. Where it is your minus 1, minus 2, right? So you're going to get minus 1 and minus 2 for the whole family. And minus 3 for your omega minus. So one thing I want to make clear here is, for kaons, my strangeness is positive. Whereas when I'm talking about my hyperons, these are all hyperons, it is negative, right? Okay. And strangeness for all non-strange particles, like your proton, your neutrons, it is all 0. And for strange particles, it is non-zero. It is either 1, minus 1, minus 2. Okay. Such values, right? Okay. Now, so having said that, let me also check like where all these S is conserved, right? So which are the interactions in which this S is going to be conserved. So first you have strong interactions, then you have electromagnetic, and you have your weak interaction. So your S is conserved in your strong interaction and your electromagnetic interaction, but it is not conserved in your weak interaction. So this is something which we must keep in mind. And let me give you one example. This I'll be solving. This you can take it as home assignment, where your pi minus, the first one is p goes to omega minus plus k plus. Let us check whether this, I mean, which kind of interaction this particular interaction is. So let me check S. So S here is, so I'm talking about strangeness, right? And this is, these are not strange particles. So 0, 0. This is sigma. So sigma minus, sigma plus, sigma minus, and sigma 0 is going to have my strangeness value as minus 1. Hence, this is minus 1. My k plus is having plus 1. So here I see my delta S is 0, right? So that means my strangeness is conserved. Let me check my I. So I, so this pions, there are 3 numbers in a particular, I mean there are 3 members in this pion family. So my isospin is 1. Proton, there are 2 members and there it's given by half, their isospin is given by half. Sigma minus, so 3 members again, so 1. K plus, K plus, 2 members in the family, isospin 1. So these things are mentioned clearly in your isospin video, so you can follow that. So this, so my I is going to follow your vector addition. So it's going to be 1 plus half, if you do it, it's going to be 3 by 2, half and 3 by 2. Again, it's going to be half and 3 by 2. So my delta I again is 0, right? So let me check my I3. So my I3, this is pi minus 1, so this is minus 1. So proton, it's plus half. Sigma minus, so my I is 1 and this is sigma minus, so it should be minus 1. And it's k plus and it's half I, so it's going to be plus half, right? So again I see here, so I3, it follows your algebraic laws of your addition. So I3 again here is your 0. Hence, we see that delta S is conserved, I is conserved, I3 is conserved. So basically meaning that the interaction which we are talking about here is strong interaction, because in strong interaction S is conserved. And if you can recall your isospin lectures, in there I have said that I and I3 is conserved in both of your strong interactions, right? So hence this particular interaction is your strong interaction. So now similarly for this particular one, for 2, that is your omega, sigma minus going to lambda 0 plus gamma. What you can do is, you can check your S, you can check your I, you can also check your I3, and then tell me which interaction this is, right? Okay. So another approximate conserved quantity is your hypercharge. Now this hypercharge is also conserved in certain interactions and it is not conserved in certain, some other interactions. So it's denoted by the letter capital Y and it is given by 2 times the average charge of the multiplets, right? Okay, so let me calculate hypercharge for these 3 particles. So sigmas, cascades and your nucleons, okay? So Y is 2 times. Now it's written average charge of the multiplets, right? The charge is plus 1, minus 1 and 0. So that basically meaning plus 1, minus 1 and 0. So divided by 3, right? So this is 0, okay? Because it's going to give me 0, so this is 0. Now, let me just write it here. So Y is 0. Now, Y here for your sigmas, it is 2 times the average charge of the multiplets, which is minus 1 plus 0 divided by 2. So this gets cancelled. So hence Y is minus 1 here. So the hypercharge is given by minus 1 here. Now for nucleons, so it is 2 into charge of neutron is 0 and that of proton is 1. Hence it is given by 1. So the hypercharge for your nucleons is 1. Right? Okay. Now this hypercharge, it is conserved in your strong interaction, in your electromagnetic interaction, but it is not conserved in your weak interactions. Okay. Now another quantity in your, like your hypercharge, which again is not your approximate, which again is your approximate conserved quantity, is parity, right? So parity is denoted by the capital P, and this is actually your mirror symmetry, right? Like when you take your space reversal, so that is your parity. So meaning, suppose you have a state which is given by psi of r. So here what I do is, I'm going to replace my r by minus r, right? So if my psi of r is given by psi of minus r, then I say that it is even parity. And if my psi of r is going to be psi of minus r, so I say that it is, the particle is in odd parity state, right? So this parity values are either plus 1 or minus 1, right? So the eigenvalues are either plus 1 or minus 1, and this parity P is conserved in your strong interaction, it is conserved in your electromagnetic interaction, but in your weak interaction this parity is not conserved.